Ranger Kooky, and I'm here on Highway 434 at a park of Lacombe, Louisiana. A park in Louisiana on Highway 434. And here's the name of the place. I'm going to take you a tour of this beautiful park I used to go to all the time. They tore a lot of buildings down since my time. So, but I want to show you this beautiful park. So enjoy. National Wildlife Refuge for the South Louisiana. This used to be an old church area where priests and nuns used to come to. Used to have more trees, but Hurricane Katrina took a few out. Some of y'all know what that is, and some of y'all don't. That used to be for making sugar out of maple. Then I could be wrong with that one, but the pots used to be that big at the time. Look at that pretty bamboo. Damn you, boy! Shaking a camera like that, people will get sick! Right here used to be an old building for the priests. It was a place where they go do exercise. It had work bikes, stuff that you could work with. It was a pretty large building. I remember walking in it a couple of times. And it was a two-story building. They had weights and activity where the priests and the nuns can go do. They changed this place, I think it was called the Holy Redeemer, and they changed it to a wildlife area where we have St. Tammany Wildlife Preserve and wildlife vehicles here. They take care and control our swamps and make sure no one's doing evil to our wildlife. And just keeping up the woods. Over there is a wall. I'm going to show you what it is. It's a back hand paddle. You know when you go around and you hit the ball with your hand and you bounce back and another guy bounce it back? Well, that I'm going to show you what that is. I'm going to take a little shortcut to it. And there's a nature trail right behind this place. I'm going to give you a look at that. This used to be backpaddling, or whatever you call it, game. Where two guys stand in a court and hit the ball towards the wall, hits to come back, and you hit it back. There's two of them. And out here is the helicopter they have out here sometimes. They land and take off. And here's the other side of the back paddle. This is your parking area. When you do come out here, you park out here and you take a walk, enjoy the whole park when you come out here. This is the classrooms for all the nuns and the priests that were out here. Right now they're using it for a wildlife management area. And over here is the church itself, and they changed it into a wildlife museum con. So we're going to take a look at that. Now, if you don't know nothing about stamps, you can get your stamps here too. Well, hello there.
All right. Coming by for a visit?
Yes, sir.
Wonderful.
I saw you about a week ago.
Oh, you did?
Was it you?
I don't know. Not me.
Well, I probably wasn't dressed up either. King snake, rat snake. No, wait a minute. Damn it! What is that name? This boxer turtle.
Life in the swamp doesn't end when the sun goes down. As the evening light fades, some animals are beginning. use the lights attached to the rail to spot the creatures of the night.
That call before? It's the sound of a red-cockaded woodpecker. The woodpecker makes this call as it flies from tree to tree in search of frost.
National Wildlife Refuges. I love adventure, don't you? Well, then, that's good. I've been called of things. Teddy, the 26th president of the United States, a conservationist and a rough rider. But today I'm going to talk to you about why I'm called a lover of birds. I've always loved birds. There is nothing like watching a file of pelicans winging their way homeward across the crimson afterglow of the sunset. When I was president, I was told about the destruction of birds and aves on nesting islands. In my day, people called plume hunters killed nesting birds for their feathers. That's because feathers were in high demand as women and some men wore them on their hats and on their clothes. I had to protect the birds for the future. First, I declared Pelican Island a federal bird reservation in 1903. A year later, on October 4, 1904, I declared Breton Island and all of the Chandelure Islands the second federal bird reservation. I saw Breton for myself in June of 1915, and it was a grand adventure. There I saw the nesting grounds for colonial seabirds like brown pelicans, royal and Caspian terns, and black skimmers. There were 33 different species of birds that lived on the island then, and today there are 23. I do wish you could have been there with me. The birds breed most plentifully. Some of these islands are nothing but sand with banks and ramparts of shells, while others are fringed with marsh grass and covered with scrub mangroves. It was a beautiful sight. The tough thing, my friends, is that there are dangers to the land we cannot control. Breton Refuge was created from parts of the Mississippi River's St. Bernard Delta, and hurricanes and occasional fierce tropical storms not only change the channels and alter the shape of the islands, but break up the islands. At one time, there was a small fishing village on Breton, but the New Orleans hurricane of 1915 forced the families to evacuate before the Category 4 storm ravaged Breton and the Chandelure Islands. Hurricanes and tropical storms were not kind to the islands in later years either. The only man-made structure, the Chandelure Lighthouse, was washed away by Katrina. Whether beset by man or nature, the islands have survived. And it's important that they continue to survive, because the birds are much too special and need the islands for nesting and as a resting spot. One bird that lives on the island year-round is the brown pelican. It may seem big, but it's the smallest of eight species of pelicans. And by Godfrey, do they have an appetite! Each pelican can eat up to 4 pounds of fish a day. Preserving the islands and protecting the birds were important to me, and it is why I created a total of 55 federal bird reservations. Today, there are over 550 national wildlife refuges. That is because the people who came after me continued the mission to protect and preserve. My niece, Eleanor, married a fine man who was also president, Franklin D. Roosevelt. He was just one of many who continued my mission. In 1935, Franklin D. Roosevelt created Delta National Wildlife Refuge on the Mississippi River below Venice, Louisiana. The Delta National Wildlife Refuge is today about 49,000 acres of land that is set aside as a place of safety for wintering migratory waterfowl. Although Breton is the only refuge I ever visited, I would have loved to have seen Delta for myself. My friends at the Fish and Wildlife Service manage the Delta National Wildlife Refuge today as well. They do a fine job of making sure the wintering waterfowl habitat at the southern end of the Mississippi Flyway is in top shape. The Delta Refuge has its challenges too. Oil and gas production has to be monitored so that wildlife and habitat on the refuge is protected. Like Breton, Delta is also at risk for damage from tropical storms and hurricanes. Delta National Wildlife Refuge took a direct hit from Katrina. People have never lived on the Delta Refuge, but today most of the visitors are fishing types and hunters who have a great time enjoying their sport in this rich habitat. Then there are other people, the people of the Fish and Wildlife Service, professionals and volunteers. Delta and Breton are both dynamic landforms, constantly being reshaped by nature in very short time frames. Proud to say that the folks who manage the land are doing their best to make sure it will be around for future generations. They create man-made crevasses and natural levees at Delta Refuge that allow sediments to spread out and build new marshlands. They are trying to restore coastal Louisiana wetlands in many areas throughout the refuges. Most of all, they are keeping to the mission of protecting the wildlife. I hope you will join me in supporting Breton and Delta National Wildlife Refuges. I so declare it, and I hope you declare it too.
Oh, yes. All right. The Refuge Vendor Center right there. Let's see if I find that trail. Some hiking trail. Looks like a road to me. I remember a while back, this used to be nothing but wooded trail. Now it's like, we just tear it up and make a road out of it. And believe it or not, my camp is no more than 2 miles or a mile from this area. So if I wanted to, I can head to my camp. There's like a trail right there. I'm gonna have to like take it right now. I was gonna go around the walking area, but it looked kind of dead and burnt trees and stuff like that, and a gravel road. I want to take you to the most and most interesting part of this park. Let's go find out. Right here in this circle right here used to be a pool or some type of water fountain right here in the middle. I'm gonna see if I can find some old pictures and post it with this video. Nice, beautiful oak trees out here. This used to be a geo-well, or whatever you call that damn well, where the water just keeps pouring out. But it looks like the water has stopped, or they stopped it. Or it is pouring out, or you can't see it. But you can see the water's been stagnated. It's kind of green-blue. Let's take a look at the pretty little pond here and a little bridge. Yeah, it's not the same like it used to be. They tore this place apart. If I remember right, there should be another little bridge over here. Yep, there it is. Barely. Bayou is really high today. This used to be the old Visitor Center. But before we go, we have to go back some to take a look at this side. This water fountain been here since I've been knowing about this place. There's like a little workbench out there for people who's jogging and you do little stretches. And this is called the Boy, I remember this used to be, none of this was here. And there was the algae well down there we saw earlier. If I'm not mistaken, this had it for the bats. Oh, it's a bird. My bad. And here's once again the Bayou Lacombe. Long time ago, they used to have an ark here. I don't know why they took it out. There was nothing wrong with the ark. It was there for many, many years. I guess they didn't like it. Really, this is a sacrificial altar where they put little children up here and they're sacrificed to their gods. Just joking. Yes, residents do stay here at the park. Look at those turtles. Let's see how close we can get before we scare them into the lake. Pond. I wonder if they can see me. Since I'm wearing camo. Oh, they can see me. Or maybe they can hear me. All creeping in. Look at all the turtles out there. I wonder if I wave, they'll come. Hi, guys! I guess not. This must be a Gia pond or a Gia. Sorry, I can't pronounce it right, but it looks like it's water going in there. And it's flowing down this ditch here. Look at all those turtles. Well, we're almost finished with this park. I hope you enjoy the video. I didn't do much talking because I want y'all to enjoy the view, not my voice. Long time ago, they used to have a swimming pool, I think right over here. They took it out for, I guess, insurance purposes, in case some kid fall in and drown. They can get sued, I guess. But it's okay to have a pond. There's the work center earlier, what we was looking at earlier. The exercise place. If I remember right, the pool was right like in this area. They had like a little bathhouse. But looks like they buried it to keep people from hurting themselves. There's that cool little waterfall we passed earlier. Well, that includes our park for the day. I hope you enjoy this video. It was a pleasure walking out here for you so you can see this beautiful park that we have in Louisiana, Lacombe, on Highway 434. Come visit it. Don't forget to sign the guest book and get your stamps, if you're into stamps. And there it is. All right, I'm Ranger Kooky. I'll see y'all next video. Look at how pretty. Look how pretty this is. All right, see you next video. Wobble along, yeah.